Thank you very much. I really appreciate the opportunity to say a few words at this type of rally. The more that we can get out there and the more that we can educate people and share stories with people and let them know the impacts of our judicial system have what they have on them, the more that we can make sure that we can make some positive changes. And the opportunity to speak at this rally in particular, to be able to say that later on in the House, we will be voting on the House resolution designating the week of April 8th through 14th as Crime Victims Awareness Week in Pennsylvania. And as a lot of you know, and as Jen mentioned, I've been an advocate for victims' voices in our criminal justice system throughout my life. It is just something that is very important to me and I feel that is missing within our very strong judicial system. And we have a lot of really strong DAs. We have a lot of people in the judicial system that really want what's best for our victims. And sometimes some things slip through the cracks. And sometimes some things don't happen. And that's what we need a Marcy's Law change for. In 2015, the last year statistics that are available, at least 750,000 Pennsylvanians were victimized by crime. And of those, more than 300,000 were victims of a violent crime. While realistically we will never get this zero down, or this number down to zero, unfortunately, we must do all that we can to help make whole those that were victimized by another individual that made a very bad decision to make somebody else hurt. Crime touches everyone, and we stand here today. Someone in Pennsylvania right now is becoming a victim of crime through no fault of their own. Whether it's an assault, abuse, harassment, stalking, theft, robbery, becoming a victim of a crime is, no matter how serious that crime may have been, is a very personal and emotional situation. We must all work together to show how we would-be criminals that we are not letting them intimidate us. We will not let them invade our communities and continue their wrongful acts on our streets and in our neighborhoods. One of the best parts of the community is when we come together. One of them, when we come together to support each other in our times of need. And I urge you to be one of those voices, one of those people that makes sure that our community is working for the betterment of the victims. Which is the goal, as Jen mentioned, of Marcy's Law, which we will need passed, and it will take a lot of work and will take every single person in this rotunda today to advocate for the need to change our Constitution in two consecutive sessions. It is a long process. It is not something done quickly. We will need a long-standing campaign to get it done, and we ask all of you for that help. Because as Jen enumerated all of the things that we need for our victims in Pennsylvania, we need to make sure that we keep moving forward, that we don't take a step back, and we keep, even when we get pushed back, because we will, sometimes we'll run into, you know, there is compromise, there's dialogue, there's all of these things that need to happen to get a constitutional change. And then we need the voters. So not only do we need the House, the Senate, and the governor, we also need the voters to make that change. And I think we can do it. It's doable. Other states have done it. And the passion that we have in this community, I think, can get it done. But we need your help, and I ask and advocate, any advocate that you can be, any force forward that we can make this stance. We need to do this in Pennsylvania and make this change, and I'm proud to be the sponsor in the House and working with the Senator to make sure that we get this done by the House and by the Senator by the Senate with the Governor's approval. So in conclusion, thank you for supporting victims and reaffirming that they are no less deserving of the rights, resources, restoration, and rehabilitation than the criminals that get them at this point. Thank you very much.